Right, let's check in with Chef Mark and get a rundown on today's recipe, which is actually stolen from your wife, Paula, Mark.
Yeah, so I've got a great recipe for you guys today, and this is from the wife, so it's good and it's great for the kids and perfect for this time of year because it's a hot pot, chicken hot pot. We've got lots of nice root vegetables in there, lots of potatoes in there and herbs, you know, to get a substantial meal. It's really easy, and the best thing about this dish, it's all cooked in one pot, so less washing up, nice and easy. And I'm going to show you how to do all that a little bit later.
Great to have you with us. We are here in the Becco kitchen for another one of Mark's delicious recipes. And this is stolen from your beautiful wife, Paula. Hi, Paula. Love your wife. She's lovely.
I think I showed her this.
Yeah, well, you showed her. Okay, well, you're going to show us now. What do we call it? A chicken hot pot.
Yeah, so chicken hot pot. So it's, you know, it's like it's cross between a stew or a soup. You know, we've got beautiful stock in there. We've got lots of vegetables, you know, really chunky, really hearty. Great for this time of the year.
Nice. We've got a whole lot of registered master builders in here. So they'll be
lapping this up.
Yeah, they'll
have to make extra.
They have to make extra, all right.
Right, so good pot, really heavy base pot. That's what you want. A good size so we can cook everything in there, you know. Right. Cut down on the washing up.
Mm-hmm.
Chicken thighs. So we've got these. You can put the skin on if you want. And, you know, that gives you extra flavour into the stew. Maybe makes it a little bit more fattier. But if you don't want the extra skin in there, just take the skin off. You can leave the bone in as well or have it boneless. It's entirely up to you. You know, we like to, Paula likes to cook it with the bone. And then we cook it.
Been picking up bits of paper and stuff. Okay, cool.
So you can cook it with the bone, but just before you serve it, just remember to take the bones out, especially if the kids are going to be eating it.
Do you want me to unfold it like that?
Yep, no, you can do.
Yeah, cool.
So nice and hot. First off, we're going to brown the chicken, all right? So we're going to get a really good colour on it, and that's going to add flavour to our stew.
Okay, cool.
So don't overcrowd the pan. Get the oil nice and hot. So we've got a good flame on there. As it increases in the heat, you can just control that flame. So we'll give it a bit of it. Don't prod it around. Let it colour. A little bit of salt and pepper.
Don't prod it around. No, I do. I do play with the meat, so you know.
Well, yeah, that's it. But I mean, if you keep playing with it and moving it, you're going to lower the temperature, so you're not going to get that brown colour, all right?
Good tip.
So a little bit of salt and pepper on now.
Okay, cool.
So we're going to build up the salt and pepper as we're going. Right. What else do we need to do now? We've got some onions and leeks. Okay. So just get an onion. We can just peel it, and you know, it's very rustic. You know, we want chunks in there. We want you know, lots of flavours, lots of textures in there. You know, we don't want to be messing around and cutting it too fine. So all I'm going to do is just sort of quarter the onion.
Yep.
And sometimes it makes it easier to peel. But every time I say that, it doesn't make it easier.
It never works, does it?
Yeah, no.
Well, I've got something for you to do too soon. Men's Health Week, so the Acuro Watch Your Score, I need you to do this for me, okay?
We'll do that.
By the end of the show, I got a horrendous score, so I just want somebody in the same league as me, okay? So you do that by the end of the
show. And you will notice there's no butter in this recipe.
Oh, there you go. See? We're looking after our house.
Right, let's have a look at our colour.
What do you reckon?
Oh, a little bit more. But we're starting to get that colour now, so that's great. You know, it's not going to take long because we've got heat in the pan. So onions, you know, nice and chunky like this. You know, we're going to cook this for an hour and a half, nice and slow to develop all those flavours. So these are going to be nice and soft. So we're not far away from the colour. I'm just going to pop the onions in now.
Okay, great.
And then some leek as well.
I love this.
And that's it. So leek's nice and soft, so it's treated like an onion. It's a bit sweeter. It's a nice root vegetable as well. But we don't want to cut it too fine, you know, because we are cooking it for a long time. So nice and chunky.
Okay,
that goes in there. So you can sort of start cooking all that down, colouring it slightly. We don't need to get too much colour on the vegetables, just on the chicken. So let's have a look at a piece of chicken.
Okay, cool. Happier?
Yeah, beautiful. So now we can turn it over. You can sort of seal the other side a little bit. And then just start cooking those vegetables down a little bit.
Okay, sweet.
I've got some spring onions as well. So these are great. Not normally sort of like in a stew recipe, so they might have been just found in the back of the fridge, what we just thrown in to use it up. But great as well, you know.
Oh,
same
great.
Again,
yeah, good.
You know, leave it in nice big chunks.
Yep.
And these are great when they're slowly cooked, you know. Normally we don't slow cook our spring onions.
Brilliant.
But you get a really good sweetness from there.
Okay, so we've got our onions, our leek, our chicken, spring onions.
Yep.
What else are we going to put in there?
All right, and then we're going to slowly add all the rest of the ingredients.
Brilliant.
We're just going to get the flavour out of that first, and then we'll come back and we'll add the rest of the stuff.
Oh, it's smelling good already, and the good thing is too, it's only one pot, less dishes. First of all, though, we're going to finish off Paula's recipe. Paula is Mark's wife. I think Mark probably showed her how to do this, though. How am I going? Am I going all right?
Oh, I don't know, you'll be getting a text in a minute. Right, so we've got some nice colour on there. We're getting a little bit of colour on the vegetables, that's okay. We don't need to worry too much about that.
Cool.
A little bit of garlic now. We don't need to chop it up. You know, it's a slow stew, really rustic, so make it easy for yourself. Chuck that in whole, we're going to get the flavour. We've got some bay leaves and a little bit of thyme as well, if you've got that. If you've got it grown in the garden, great, just snip it off, throw it in.
Nice.
Give that a good stir around.
Okay.
And then this is up to you now, so this is sort of an optional stage. If you want the stew to sort of cook down and have a little bit of body into the stock, you can add a little bit of flour to this stage. And this is when you want to add it. So you just sort of dissolve it in and you can cook it out a little bit and then slowly add your stock so you won't go lumpy.
Okay, cool.
Right. If you're gluten-free or you don't want to put flour in or you want it nice and thin, just don't add the flour. That's all good. But I'm just going to put a little bit in, just sort of like a teaspoon or two. That goes in. You stir that around.
Okay, cool.
And then we are nearly ready.
You may be looking at the bottom of this thinking, oh, what's going on there? But that's all flavour. It is all...
it is. All right. You've learned. It's all flavour. Right, and then I've got some carrots as well. So same again. Just cut them nice and chunky, nice and rustically. And then they're going to go in.
Great.
And, we didn't need that one anyway.
It's all right.
And then we've got some stocks. So some chicken stock, some beef stock. You know, it's up to you as well, you know, if you want to use all beef or all chicken, depending on what you want to do. But it's quite nice to sort of mix them up. So I've got one third beef, two thirds chicken.
Brilliant.
So the flour's all stirred in.
Yeah.
And then that goes in now. You know, if you wanted, you could add some wine at this stage.
Okay.
You know, that's all good.
Oh, yeah.
But this is a family favourite for the kids. The kids absolutely love this, so that's what the reason why we don't put any wine in.
Not good for the kids.
I mean, it's fine because you're cooking it out, but it's just, this is one of their favourite dishes, actually.
Great, and that's going to release all the flavours from the bottom of the pan as well. It's
deglazing.
Beautiful deglazing.
That's it, and we want to bring that up to the boil now, and then we've just got some nice agria potatoes as well, and then cut them nice and chunky, and they're going to go in. We'll bring it up to the boil, turn it down to a simmer. You can pop a lid on there and just slowly cook it. The longer you cook it, the more flavour.
Okay, and roughly, what's your minimum slow cook?
You probably want to be, probably about an hour to an hour and a half if you've got the time, you know. This is a great one to do in the morning.
Yep.
You know, Paula always gets up, does all the packed lunches, puts this on, and then, you know, you've got the rest of the day while the kids are at school just to relax and,
brilliant,
you know, do what you want, and then it's ready to go at dinner time.
I love it. Yeah, some good hearty vegetables in there, some nice flavours coming through with the mix that we've got in there. This is going to be sensational. All in one pot, which we love. Mark, this smells incredible. Can't wait to taste it. What are you going to do tomorrow?
Well, I'm going to do my take on a Greek classic.
Oh, good.